Ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to you all. How are you doing? You're awake? That's good. Well, I've been asked to be short, so I'll be short. Today, new models are emerging all the time in how to transform every aspect of your life. However, the problem is these new transformation methods they are not coming into the curriculums of the university. If there are any universities that wish to challenge me, they are welcome to that. From what I listen to students, they are physics students, they are very good in their thing. But in life, when they come out of university, they have challenges. There's a lot of innovation in education today, but I think, in my opinion, there's less innovation in the actual curriculums of the university. They are very hard to change. It takes too long to change them. I think universities have to focus on the curriculums. And what I mean by curriculums, I will step back and say, I think a lot of universities, when you talk to them, they say, oh, we have 30,000 students a year. So basically, I look at them and I think they're churning out students. The production factor, it's just like he said, it's a quantity over quality. And what I mean by quality is, if the universities would focus on their own internal report card that says if they have followed their students over 5-6 years, they don't have to disclose that to anybody, but over 5-6 years, how successful in life are their students? And if they find a deficiency, they should go and amend the curriculum to address those issues. And most of them, every professor is either teaching physics, science, biology, you know, whatever. But collectively, they need to build a student up so he can be his own economic unit and be successful in life. So what I think lacks, when I speak to students, I think the universities don't teach basic things of life. They don't teach the process of thought. Because thought and belief literally change the world. It's your thought and belief. But I think thinking should be a subject taught. How to think right, what are the processes of thinking? Some of these, they are within Indian culture, they are there. But at university level, it does not matter whether you are a math student. You should be also taught the process of thinking. To be taught how to be a better problem solver. Most of our life we are all problem solvers. But there is a process to solve problems. So in universities, part of the curriculum should be how to, and in life we have to solve our problems. It doesn't matter whether you are a mathematician. But life's problems are different from mathematics. So I think, I am talking now, everything I am talking about is speech sense when I meet students. So that should be there. I also find that the challenge in making decisions is a big issue. So I don't know any questions in the universities to include decision making processes, which are, there's a process in how you make a decision. And I find people can't make a decision and they get stuck. Even if they have academic knowledge, they blame the universities. I know students, they say, oh, I've been let down by the society, I've got a master's degree, haven't got a job. So there is an issue there. So the universities don't promise you a job or successful life. They give you basic foundation. But within that foundation, if they could teach the process of making decisions. And basically for me, for the students, there are only three types of decisions. One, that you can reverse without a penalty. It's easy to make. You miss a road, you turn back and come back. Now, it's easy decision. Second one is a penalty on a decision. You choose a subject, you don't like it, you have every right to change it, you pay a penalty, you pay the extra fee. The third is irreversible decision, which means if you jump from 14-story building, at the 7th floor, you cannot say, I am going to change my mind. That decision needs a hell of a lot of time, process, writing down. So So it's not very difficult to make a decision. So long you know how to make a decision and what is the cost of your decision. So a lot of people focus on decisions that are so reversible or the penalties are so less. So don't get entangled in that. I find a lot of students are entangled in the process of decision making. I'm trying to be very short, but I will skip a few things. The other thing is, I'm going to address this to the students. You have to be self-motivated. University just give you a foundation. It has to be coming from the stomach. It's got to be the desire to succeed. That has to be there. That can't be necessarily taught. You could have gurus, you could have your team of mentors that help you out, but you need that in you to succeed. I would like also to address the university. There are lots of new books out there. Why can't you bring part of these into the curriculums? There are books, very simple books, How to Make Friends, Influence People, 7 Habits. Teach the students about money. Universities have to, schools, high schools have to teach about money. Students don't understand money. Money, they don't know that if they buy a car of 30,000, actually the cost is 60, because Justin takes half of your money away anyway. So you need to earn $60,000 to buy a $30,000 car. They don't understand that. They don't understand that $60,000 salary is less than $5,000 for you, because the rest you're paying your rent, the landlord is getting rich, you're paying the bay, Eaton Center, everybody else. So you must understand money. Money is very important. So I think universities should bring financial knowledge irrespective of what subject somebody takes. It is very important. I think that is missing in a lot of students. Unless you are in the business studies, I think even if you are a historian, financial is very important. So we should be brought into it. For the students, I leave you with one thought. Just improve 1% a day. 1% is nothing. Before you go to bed, think, did I do better than yesterday by 1%? Believe me, trust me. In a year, you'll be 365% better than anybody else around you. In 5 years, you'll beat the socks off anybody in this room, including your professors. But just focus, go home, focus on that 1% a day improvement. Before you go to bed, think, did you invest in yourself? Did you improve yourself every day by only 1%? Thank you very much. Have a great day.